This freedom alone makes it possible for people to formulate their own views and opinion on a proper basis.
Could you please tell me what are the facts of that case which you have quoted now?
Yes, Your Lordship.
Briefly.
And secondly, this act, particularly this act, this 2019 act, how is it, does it curtail your freedom of speech and expression? You are not prohibited from expressing anything. Article, you were referring to Article 19A, no?
Yes,
am
yes.
I right? Then this particular act doesn't in any way restrict your freedom of speech and expression. Whatever you can, in three languages you can. Where is
indeed,
where is the restriction, ma'am?
Indeed, your lordship. Indeed, your lordship. But in the case, then the central is doing that, it is implementing only Hindi language as a compulsory language, as an official language. But in the 8th
Yes, please.
In the 8th schedule of Indian Constitution, it has clearly stated that there are 22 languages, and in that there is Hindi language and Tamil language also. But here it has not stated that Hindi is not a national language, but it is one of the official language. And comparing to that, Tamil has a classical language. It has also considered as a classical language, looking at its origin, because it is more ancient than Sanskrit. So here, our case is that the central should also take the Tamil language as the first language.
Do you agree with the thing that the roots of both the languages are Devanagari?
No.
The Sanskrit also draws its basis from Devanagari script, the Tamil language. Sorry.
Pardon me, Lord.
Tamil language also draws its the growth from the Devanagari script only, no?
Indeed, Your Lordship, but Hindi is from Devanagari script and Tamil is from Brahmi script.
That's what, basis are one and the same. Okay, proceed.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. Here next, further, right to education is a fundamental right, being a basis of right of life, following from Article 21. Of the Constitution. By virtue of Article 21A, right to free and compulsory primary education is a fundamental right guaranteed to all children of the age of 6 to 14 years, and it is guaranteed a duty on the parent, which was added in 82nd Amendment in 2002, which was clearly stated the parent have their duty, because there is fundamental rights, because it is stated in fundamental duties of 51A, Article K. In this, Your Lordship, here the center don't have the right to impose the particular language on the citizen of the states, because it is the right of parent to choose the language on it. So here the center don't have the right to impose the only single language on the children as the first language.
Just a minute. That right of the parents to which you refer to, madam, from
yes,
which article of constitution that arises? The right of the parents to give education to their children in the language of their choice is a right, you say? Okay, fine, no problem. From which article of the constitution it emerges?
Indeed, Your Lordship, it is not a right, but it is a duty of the parent.
Could you please, which of the provisions?
Duty is all right. Duty, of course, it is the duty of the parents to upbring their children. Not nice. And give education in the language of their choice. Fine. From where is that article? Where?
It is stated in the fundamental duties.
Fundamental duties. Duties are duties enforceable? Duties are duties. They are not enforceable. Just
because,
like directive principles of state policy, which are not enforceable, duties are also not enforceable. If Indeed. I don't perform any some duty enshrined in Article 51, the state has no power to arrest me and put me behind bars. It's my choice. It's not enforceable. Is it not? What do you?
And the right to education being a species is a fundamental right to choose the medium of instruction even in primary stage of the parent.
Correct.
Yes, Council's permission to start further.
Yeah.
Here, in the Article 26 of the Indian Constitution, provides that every religious domination has the right to establish and maintain an institution for charitable purposes, which includes an educational institution. This right is available to minority religious domination. But the Hindi Language Implementation Act 2019 struck down the establishment of such religious educational institutions in India. The same thing was explained in the case of S.T. Stephens College versus University of Delhi. All India Report 1992, 1, so Supreme Court cases 558. It was held that regulations, however, shall not have the effect of depriving the right of minority of to educate their children in their institution. This is a privilege which is implied in the right conferred by Article 30, Clause 1. So, in this present case, through Hindi Language Implementation Act 2019 allows to establish of educational institutions medium of Hindi language only and struck down the right of minority to establish educational institutions in their language guaranteed by Article 30, Clause 1.
What are the facts in that case? Stephens College case? Why they were before the Supreme Court? In what context the court has held like that?
Indeed, because of minority educational institutions.
Yes.
Because of minorities, sir.
No, what was the apple of discord? Why they were before the court? Which action of the state they were challenging?
Pardon me, Your Lordship.
Why if they were before the court, which action of the university or state or organization they were challenging before the court?
They were challenging because the minority rights were violated in the University of Delhi by what the university. Much obliged, Your Lordship. In the further, Article 29, Clause 1, right to minority have the right to establish and administer. Pardon me, Your Lordship. The Constitution itself stated that in 29, Clause 1, every section of the Indian Constitution has its fundamental right. Pardon me, Your Lordship.
29.1 says any section of the citizens residing in the territory of India or any part thereof, having a distinct language, script or culture of its own, shall have the right to conserve the same. So in what way this act destroys your right? They have not prohibited you from speaking Tamil. How do you will notify this?
Yes, sir.
Achha.
Pardon me.
Fine. I am told that your time is over.
You can just sum up.
Okay, you can sum up this point.
Complete.
Fine, madam. Huh? You are good on issue number one, no?
Yeah, yes, Your Lord.
Yeah. Okay, fine. You want to say something? We can give you 1 or 2 more minutes. If you want to conclude.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. I want to continue.
Please.
With 2 more minutes.
Yeah.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. And Article 30, Clause 1, which says that minority have the right to establish and administer educational institutions based on the religion or language of their own choice. Sure. In the case of Ahmedabad State Xavier College versus State of Gujarat, All India Report 1954, Supreme Court page number 1389 states that each and every person has a right to get education in their own choice.
Correct.
Establishing and administering education institutions of their choice for the purpose of giving their children the best general education, which education for the overall development. And hence, I would like to conclude that Indian Language Implementation Act of 2019, the policy which has made by the union is totally arbitrary action on the state, and it violates the Article 14, Article 19 Clause 1A Sub Clause A, Article 19 Clause 1 Sub Clause G, Article 21, Article 21A, Article 26, Article 29 Clause 1, and Article 30 Clause 1. Oh. If the bench is satisfied with all these issues, my co-counsel will deal with further issues 3 and 4.
Okay. Much obliged. Thank you. Who is now this candidate also has happened 15 minutes. Okay. Who is addressing? N2.
I think you need to unmute yourself.
N1.
Pardon me.
Who is N2? Yes. You are. Achha.
Council seek permission to start the argument in advance of fourth issue.
Yes. Okay, please carry on.
Yes. The fourth issue, the state can decide the medium of instruction at the early stage of education and what can be considered as a mother tongue. It is most humbly submitted before this court that the state can decide the medium of instruction at the early stage of education. Under Article 162 of the Indian Constitution, the extent of the executive power of the state, subject to the provision of this constitution, the executive power of the state shall extend to the matters with respect to which the legislative of the state has power to make laws. In the case of Gujarat University versus Krishna Ranganath Mudolkar, All India Report 1963 Supreme Court case 703, the state government has an executive power within its legislature, and therefore the prescribing medium of instruction as well within power of the state government. Hence, in the present case, the state Tamil Nadu, through its executive power, can prescribe a particular language as a medium of instruction, acting within a power conferred under the constitution. Your Honor, I further submitted that the education come under the concurrent list of entry number 25. Both union and the state legislature have a power to regulate on it. Under
you
such
made entry, which entry you said, ma'am?
Entry number 25.
In the concurrent list.
Yes.
Would you please read it?
Pardon me, Your Lordship.
You are telling that you derive power from the entry 25.
Yes, Your Lordship.
Please read that entry in the schedule. Concurrent list.
Education, including technical education, medical education, and universities, subject to the provisions of the entries 63, 65, 66, and 66 of the list, and vocational and technical training of a labor.
Do you think that the prescribing a medium of instruction, the power of the state, is sourced from this entry?
Indeed, Your Lordship, education is a concept of a national wealth. So the state and the union both have a power to make laws related to it, because it is a benefit of the peoples in the state also, as well as the union.
Yes, proceed.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. On such power, the state may prescribe a particular medium of instruction at the early stage of education.
Yes. Hello.
You need to unmute yourself.
Unmute.
In a case, PM Pai Foundation versus State of Karnataka 1994, All India Report 3272, the state has power to regulate on education in the true interest of the efficiency of instruction, academic standard, discipline, health, and public order, etc. Hence, in the present case, the central imposes Hindi as the medium of instruction. Your Honor, I would like to make a practical tell about practical implement of it. Hindi is based on an Indo-Aryan language, and Tamil is an Indo-Dravidian based. So if we implement Hindi language as the primary stage of education, it will cause burden and stress on our children. So Tamil should be implemented at the primary stage, and afterwards, the completion of the primary education, Hindi should be implemented. So it will remove the stress and trauma on the children. And further submitted that, Your Honor, after the independence, states have been organized on the basis of a language, and the state have a power to declare a language as the official language of a state under Article 345. Also, Article 347, which empowers the president to recognize a language which is spoken by a substantial portion of a population of the state. Therefore, Tamil is a language. The Tamil Language Implementation Act 2019 is not waiver of the constitution, and majority people in the Tamil Nadu are speaking Tamil. So therefore, the state justified the medium of instruction in a Tamil.
You mean to say that the people who are serving in public sector undertaking or the central government who hail from a different state are also should be compelled to learn in Tamil medium of Tamil medium only? Suppose a person from Delhi is transferred to Tamil Nadu, whose children are at the higher level or the primary level of education. You are going to compel them to start their learning from Tamil medium?
Indeed, the Tamil Language Implementation Act of the state legislature is not neglected by any minority or any other persons of the center. It's the intention of the legislation is to preserve the Tamil language culture, because if the implementation of the Hindi in a state legislature, in the state education also, it will destroy the language tradition.
It is already included in the 8th schedule. Tamil language is included in the 8th schedule in which year?
Indeed, the answer of the question is in further arguments.
Okay.
So if we Tamil is having a rich culture, so the children from the Tamil Nadu, they can know about the history of the Tamil Nadu, so they implement the Tamil. If we neglect the Tamil, the language is reflects the community and represent the culture. If we avoid the language, it lost its uniqueness. So to preserve the diversity of the nation, diversity of the language, the Tamil Language Implementation Act is passed. So the state legislature intention is not to harm any minority. The minority's rights are conferred under Article 29 and 13 of the Constitution.
Does the state has the power to implement an act which overrides the central enactment?
Indeed, Your Lordship.
Could you please enlighten us, where does the state derive such power?
Uh, 162 of the Indian Constitution.
So 162 deals with the... Now, I am asking a specific question, whether a state has a power to make a legislation which is inconsistent or which overturns or which runs contrary to the central legislation on the same subject.
Yes, Your Lordship. The constitutionality of a statute, a law to be a valid must conform the constitutional norms. The notwithstanding of the statute arise from the various constitutional violation, that is violation of the scheme of distribution of powers between the center and the state, and second, infringement of fundamental rights and violation of the other constitutional restriction and limitation. The non-obstantive clause under 246 clause 1 of the Constitution, where the primarily the legislation would prevail notwithstanding the executive power of the state legislature to make the laws by reason of the Article 244 clause 1. Your Lordship, the meaning of non-obstantive clause under the Constitution was impressed by the Apex Court in the case of R.S. Ranganath versus State of Karnataka, states that non-obstantive clause cannot be construed as taking away the portion outside the limitation on the amending power. It has to be harmoniously construed, the constituent with the founding principles of the basic structure of the Constitution. Yet another case, Chief Information Commissioner versus State of Gujarat, the Apex Court held that the special enactment cannot override by the later general enactment simply because the latter opens up the non-obstante cause unless there is a clear inconsistency between the two obligations. So we can say that a clause of non-obstante are not always be considered as a residing clauses. In fact, they to be widened so the clause will remove all barriers which might arise any other law in a way of principal provisions of the particular obstante clauses are there. So also we need to follow the principle of harmonious interpretation. The presumption is that the conflict of repugnancy was indeed by the former between the various provisions of the constitution. So the provisions of the constitution should not be interpreted as to affect the reconciliation between the conflicting provisions. So that if possible effect could be given to all. This is known as the rule of harmonious construction. This has been applied to interpret the entries of various legislative lists and landmark judgment of the harmonious construction is seen in and also Kerala's education bills.
Could you please tell me the dates on which these two legislation came into force? The first Hindi Language Implementation Act and your Tamil Language Implementation Act.
June 2019, Hindi Implementation Act was enacted, and in July 2019, Tamil Implementation Act was enacted.
Please, I would like to correct you. The presidential approval for Hindi language was given on 8th March 2019, and Tamil state language implementation was received assent on 13th June 2019. It was brought into force on 1st July 2019.
Pardon me, Your Lordship.
Yes, please.
If the bench is satisfied with fourth issue, council seek permission to move to fifth issue.
Yes, please. Yes, please.
The parliament has a unilateral power to decide the medium of transaction in constitutional institution, including judiciary. According to Article 345, subject to the provisions of the Article 346 and 347, the legislature of the state may by law adopt any or one languages in a state or a Hindi as the official language for all purpose of the states, and further submitted that under Article 348, the language used in Supreme Court and High Court and acts or bills, etc., in which Article 348 clause 1 lays down that in all proceedings, Supreme Court, High Court, and all acts, bills, ordinances, bylaws, etc., English language until the parliament by law provides. But the clause 2 and clause 3 are the general exception to the Article 348. According to it, Article 348 clause 2, notwithstanding anything in the subclause A of clause 1, the governor of the state use Hindi language or any other language used for any official purpose of the state and in proceedings of the High Court having the principal seat in state, provided that nothing in the clause shall apply to the judgment, decree or order passed or made by such High Court. So the state legislature have a power to use the regional language in its proceedings, and coming to the judgment decree, the official language act 1963, in which Section 7, which enables the High Court to use the language other than English in its judgment, etc. But then it must be accompanied by the translation thereof. So, hence the provisions of the argument. Hence,
proceed. Because see, you are mentioning Article 348.
Yes, Your Lordship.
If you look at the feature number 5, in the Hindi language implementation, they have taken care of it. The language of Supreme Court and all High Court shall be Hindi as from the date notified by the President to this effect.
Yes, Your Lordship.
On that count, your argument don't survive.
But in Tamil, the regional language also be used. in the High Court proceedings.
Okay, proceed.
So hence it can be concluded that the state have a power to decide the medium of transaction in judiciary institution under Article 348 Clause 2 and the Section 7 of the Official Language Act 1963. Under Article 348 Clause 3 provides an exception provision to the Article 348 Clause 1 Subclause B in favor of the state legislature. The state legislature may prescribe use of any language other than English for a bills, acts passed by itself or subordinate legislation made thereunder. But then English translation is thereof is mandatory. So, and also the Section 6 of the Official Language Act 1963, state may prescribe any other than Hindi for use in acts, bills, ordinances passed by the legislature of the state. Hence, the state may decide the medium of transaction in legislation institution also. It can be concluded that Parliament have a power to the Parliament power to decide the medium of transaction is not absolute. So the state also have a power to decide the medium of transaction of various constitutional institution, including judiciary. If the bench is satisfied with fifth issue, Council seek permission to move to prayer. Wherefore, in the light of the issues raised, argument advanced and authority cited, the petitioner most respectfully pleased to the Tamil Implementation Act 2019 does not violate of the fundamental rights and or pass any other order it may deem fit in the interest of justice, equity and good common sense.
Okay. Yes, time is over. Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes.
The council seeks permission from the bench to collectively address them as your lordships.
Yes, permitted.
Much obliged, your lordship. Your lordship, the council seeks permission to start screen sharing.
No facts, we are aware of it. You can proceed with your legal submissions.
Much obliged, your lordship. Good morning, your lordship. This is the council appearing on behalf of the respondent, the state of Tamil Nadu, in the dispute between Union of India versus state of Tamil Nadu. Before this Honorable Supreme Court of India. Your Lordship, the Council will make submissions on issues relating to Hindi Language Implementation Act 2019, the Tamil Language Implementation Act 2019, and the power of Parliament to impose one language throughout the nation. And my co-counsel will make submissions on issues relating to states' ability to decide medium of instruction and the power of Parliament to decide medium of transaction by various constitutional institutions, including the judiciary. First and foremost, Your Lordship, my learned petitioner is a bit confused in the matter of parties in this dispute present before this Honorable Supreme Court. Four petitions were filed challenging the Hindi Language Implementation Act and Tamil Language Implementation Act. Petition 1 was filed by Mr. Rajesh, an employee of HSNL, challenging the Tamil Language Implementation Act before High Court of Mumbai. Petition 2 was filed by Telugu People's Association of Coastal Tamil Nadu against both the legislation before Supreme Court of India. Petition 3 was filed by a Tamil-based NGO by the name of Tamil Bhasha Swadhimani Sangh challenging the central legislation before High Court of Mumbai. And Petition 4 was filed by the central government challenging the Tamil Language Implementation Act 2019 introduced by the state of Tamil Nadu before High Court of Mumbai.
That is you?
Yes, sir. We are... yes,
you are challenger. The final one. Last petition was challenged by you.
Your Lordship, the last petition... we are the respondent state of Tamil Nadu. The last yes. petition was challenged by the Union of India.
Do you represent Union of India or only Tamil Nadu?
Only Tamil Nadu, Your Lordship.
Okay.
The Supreme Court, seeing the same question of language and mother tongue, transferred all the cases and clubbed them into one petition under Article 139A, much like the COVID petition which was clubbed by the Supreme Court last year. And thus, the parties should remain the same. So the state of Tamil Nadu cannot be a petitioner in any of the present cases, as no petition was filed by the state of Tamil Nadu before High Court or Supreme Court. Your Lordship, the facts and laws pertaining to this case are so intertwined that separating them would not be in the interest of justice. Therefore, the council seeks permission to proceed with the first submission.
Please proceed.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. For the first submission, the council submits that the Hindi Language Implementation Act is violative of fundamental rights of citizens and amounts to discrimination based on language. The Hindi Language Implementation Act 2019 was enacted by the Union of India, the act was passed by both houses in the parliament and received assent by the president on 8th March 2019. Some of the salient features of Hindi Language Implementation Act are: the language of Supreme Court and all High Court shall be Hindi. All the central government undertakings such as port, aerodromes, banks, financial institutions shall be compulsorily opt for Hindi language as the medium of official correspondence. And all central government transactions shall be in Hindi language. Changing the language of all government undertakings and judiciary is violative of Article 14 of the Constitution of India, which gives equal protection of law and equality before the law to the people. Hindi Language Implementation Act 2019 mandatorily imposes Hindi and creates an arbitrary and unreasonable discrimination between people who are not proficient in Hindi language and people who are. Discrimination on the basis of language is arbitrary and has no reasonable nexus to the objective that is thought to be achieved by the Hindi Language Implementation Act. Thus, it is violative of Article 14.
Hindi language. Not learned Hindi.
No, you see, it's only asking by virtue of this bill, they are trying to mention you that you one of the language you should be learning is Hindi. They are not imposing a media form instruction should be in Hindi.
Much obliged.
Already, as a third language, every student is learning Hindi. Instead of third language, they mentioned that you may make it a first language.
Much obliged, Your Lordship, for the question. Your Lordship, one of the provisions of Hindi Language Implementation Act is all the government undertakings and transactions shall be compulsorily in Hindi language, and non-implementation of the same would add penal consequences. This is a clear imposition of Hindi language to the people. If I may proceed with the argument.
Yeah, proceed.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. The Hindi Language Implementation Act nowhere mentions on how the current working professionals in High Court and other central government undertakings who are not proficient in Hindi should make the transition to Hindi language in the respective profession. If any judge is compelled to deliver a judgment in a language with which he is not well versed, it might become extremely difficult for him to work judicially.
No, for which they are given a rider there. If you read it completely,
yes, sir,
the silent feature number 5, that's not immediately it is coming into force in the Supreme Court and the High Court.
Yes, sir.
The language of the Supreme Court and in High Court shall be Hindi as from the date notified by the President to that effect.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. But the provision also never states how, if the central government is making
every act will have their own rule making powers. They want to authorize, they want to delegate those powers to some of the state governments or the officers or a designated officer.
Yes, Your Lordship.
So the rules will be there. Subordinate legislation will come. The procedural law will be prescribed in future. That is why they have mentioned as on from the date notified by the President to this effect.
Much obliged, Your Lordship, the question. But
so
Your Lordship,
that will take care of your apprehension that immediately judges are compelled to read Hindi.
Yes, Your Lordship.
Provided with the training in the judicial academies. And thereafter, gradually it can be implemented.
Much obliged, but yet the act still imposes Hindi on a particular section of people who don't want to do their profession in that particular language. It's clearly violative of Article 14 in that sense. And Your Lordship, it's also violative of Article 19, subsection 1, subclause G. If I may proceed with my submission.
Please, you don't much seek permission, you go on proceeding.
Proceed.
The act adversely affects their right to freely practice their profession and right to livelihood. Using Hindi language as a medium of transaction in High Court state with non-Hindi speaking majority would be violative of Article 19, subsection 1, subclause G, which grants freedom to practice trade and profession. Further, Hindi Language Implementation Act is based on the vague assumption that everyone in non-Hindi speaking state working in a High Court of that state is not only capable of understanding Hindi but also has excellent fluency and command over Hindi. This will not only result in lawyers and judges who aren't fluent in Hindi to not be able to work in High Court to the utmost competence. The Hindi Language Implementation Act also curtails right to livelihood under Article 21 of the Constitution, which was established by the Supreme Court to be born out of Article 21, right to life and liberty in Olga Tellis versus Bombay Municipal Corporation. in which the Supreme Court of India established.
You are creating an exercise. We really don't know. Article 20, how your rights under Article 21 are violated? If just your, Hindi has mentioned as one of the language.
Your lordship forcing people to work in a particular language, forcing lawyers to argue in a particular language is also curtailing their right to practice to earn their livelihood, because they're because your lordship they'll be forced to work in a particular language they do not know.
So if on the let us take an example. Yes. In a traffic thing, you are supposed to go from left side your drive, okay? Then if a particular man doesn't like it, if he wants to go on the right side, is it then Article 21 applies to him?
No, your lordship. Article
21 is his right to go from any side. He will not obey any law. So yes. Article 21 is infringed, and therefore he should be given liberty to drive anyway as per his will and wish on the roads. Is it possible?
How is personal liberty or life is affected by virtue of this enactment? We are not able to understand.
Your lordship, much obliged for the question, your lordship. Article 21 also has a right to livelihood. That is to earn the money to support your life, to eat, to live a daily life which has personal liberty. And the right to livelihood is also a very major section of right to life, because it has such a wide purview, which was established in the particular case, your lordship.
Right to livelihood comes within the ambit of Article 21.
Yes, no, your lordship. It was established in the case of all that.
See, sir. See, no person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except according to procedure established by law. Is Article 21.
Yes, your lordship.
In what way this act curtails your liberty?
Your lordship.
Takes away your life.
19.1G, okay, I agree. Livelihood. But 21 is you are equating it to right to livelihood. Somewhere it's not reflected in the provision.
Much obliged for the question, your lordship. Your lordship, in Article 21, right to life, time and time again, Supreme Court has shown that it has such a wide purview. And in the particular case of Olga Tellis versus Bombay Municipal Corporation, again, the Supreme Court has established that Article 21, right to life, also includes right to livelihood. That is to earn the money to support yourself.
Yes, that is true. Okay.
Much obliged, your lordship.
Olga Tellis. Okay.
Much obliged, your lordship. Further, also relying on 216 non-feasibility of introduction of Hindi language report by the Law Commission, Honorable Justice Y.V. Chandrachud was of the opinion that neither the Supreme Court or the High Court should be ever asked to deliver judgments in Hindi. The judges of these courts are drawn from all over India, and they are not all conversant with Hindi, and such transition would not be advantageous for the judges or lawyers. Language is a highly emotional issue for the citizens of any nation. It has a great unifying force and is a powerful instrument for national integration. No language should be thrust on any section of the people against their will, since it is likely to become counterproductive. Thus, Hindi Language Implementation Act, as it is being imposed on people of India, will become counterproductive to the administration of justice. If your lordship is satisfied with my first submission, may the council move on to his second submission. Much obliged, your lordship. For the second submission, the council submits Tamil Language Implementation Act 2019 is not ultra-vires of the constitution. Tamil Language Implementation Act 2019 was passed by the state of Tamil Nadu, and it virtually overrode every provision in Hindi Language Implementation Act 2019. It came in force on 1st July 2019, and some of its provisions are that Tamil shall be medium of instruction in all schools up to 10th standard. The language of subordinate judiciary and High Court of Tamil Nadu shall be Tamil from the date notified by the governor to this effect, and all government transactions shall be in Tamil.
What is the object behind that is in making this law?
Your lordship, it's under Article.
What do you want to achieve?
Promotion of mother. Promotion of Tamil language, your lordship.
Promotion of Tamil language.
Yes,
but if you look at that particular act, it clearly overrides the central enactment which was passed just some few months earlier.
Yes, your lordship.
Then but, does it? Are you not violating Article 254 too?
Yes, lordship. Language is not a list in any that is language is not a legislative list.
No, you have made a legislation now which is runs completely contrary to the central legislation.
Yes, Your Lordship.
So yes, that particular on the face of it, it is hit by Article 254(2).
Yes, Your Lordship. But the, much obliged for the question, Your Lordship. The State Act is only the only has effect in the state, and it comes under the state list, Your Lordship. The Parliament will not have power in the state unless it's an emergency.
And I think you are missing my question. If you read Article 254, which deals with the inconsistency between law made by the Parliament and laws made by the legislature of a state.
Yes, Your Lordship.
For a state to make a law on the same field, which runs contrary to the law made by the Parliament, what is the mandatory requirement?
That the matter should be on the
Constitution. Pardon?
The matter should be, if the matter is on the state list, Your Lordship, this second, the state has the power to make laws relating to the, any of the matters in the state list. And the Parliament still won't be able to exercise its
Where do you derive such power?
Your Lordship, schedule 7, the state list second.
Which entry?
Your Lordship, entry.
You think that schedule 7, the entries in the schedule 7 derives the source of power?
I'm not sure, Your Lordship.
Okay, please. Please proceed.
Much obliged, Your Lordship. All competitive exams shall be conducted in Tamil and English language only. State of Tamil Nadu enacted the Tamil Language Implementation Act in pursuance of Article 345 of the Constitution, which grants states power to adopt its regional language or any language as official language for the official purposes of the state. Further, implementing a language which is largely spoken by the people of the state will increase transparency in working of the government and the judiciary. Tamil Language Implementation Act also makes Tamil language the official medium of instruction in all schools up to 10th standard. Relying on the Supreme Court judgments of Usha Mehta versus State of Maharashtra, where the Supreme Court held policy of inculcating a regional language as a compulsory subject, the court noted that since a large part of official business of the state is conducted in a specific language, it would be useful for the students in school to learn the said language, and also linguistic minorities would do well to learn the regional language as this would promote national and cultural.
Could you please tell me what are the facts of that case?
Yes, Your Lordship.
What was the challenge before this court in that case?
Yes, Your Lordship. Much obliged for the question. State of Maharashtra made Marathi a compulsory language in all schools across the state. The petition was filed.
Not a medium of instruction.
Not a medium of instruction, Your Lordship. Only a compulsory subject, and the petition
but
was
only filed. Only as a language.
Yes, Your Lordship. And the petition.
Yes, continue.
The petition was filed to challenge the constitutionality of Marathi.